Wakey, wakey, Doctor. What am I doing? Breakfast? It's a fairly common occurrence around the beginning of the day. Eggs and bacon. I never get tired of the taste of eggs and bacon, despite me never forgetting. I also never forget the taste of tea. I'm not sure what it is, but the healing properties of my homeland have never really left me. Whether it's habit or genuine health benefit, I'm not sure, my dear doctor. But still. May I set you a plate? You're trying to place me, aren't you, Doctor? Just as you did when you first met me. Is it really so hard to believe that I, a simple man of simple tastes, can find happiness in the little things? Despite what we experienced last night, I have to say I am fully aware of my unique tastes and delights, but I have to say that I, too, as I recall, Doctor, you too seem to be awakened to new experiences last night. And if I recall correctly, they were not entirely unpleasant to you. Oh yes, I remember your face when I did certain things. But come, we are wasting time. After breakfast, we will venture into Gotham. And there, we are meeting someone rather special. You may know her as Poison Ivy. Does she know we're coming? No. No, she doesn't. I thought we'd pop in and see how she's doing. She has something that I require for my cure. Yes. If you remember, Doctor, I am dying. There's simply too much information running around my head. And well, the human brain is a memory bank, after all. Eventually, my brain will become so overladen with information, both useless and important, short term and long, that my body will begin to simply shut down. There's simply no more information I can take. And this is an inconvenience. As blissful as it would be to simply let go of all these useless memories, I have far too much to do yet. Such as what? Spending time with you, of course, Doctor. Come, bacon and eggs, and then on the road again. We do not have much time. I want to make the most of this morning. Is there anything you can do to help? You are an extraordinary soul, Doctor. You do realize that, don't you? Well, look at everything that I've done. To you, to the people around you, to the people you knew, and yet you are still willing to help. When it involves me dying, well, perhaps. I know you want to help, Doctor. But I think, in life, there are some things that you simply have to do yourself. It's nothing personal, but actually, I've thought of something you can help me with. Oh, no, don't worry about it now. I'll let you know when we're nearer to the actual occasion where you can be of some use. Eat up, Doctor. And we'll hit the road once more.
On Marcus Kincaid. Activating the drone system now.
Actually, it's funny enough you mentioned that, sir. One of the drones on a route coming straight into Gotham picked up Marcus and indeed the young doctor as they left an abandoned diner early this morning. What would you like to do, sir?
Alfred, we need to separate Marcus from that doctor. I have a feeling that he's got something sinister planned. Especially since he's returning to Gotham. I just wish I knew what he was planning. Now, if this is the route which I think we established, we can set up an ambush as he comes into Gotham here.
Very good, sir.
Any idea where he is now?
I can stay with him, sir, if you desire.
Yes. Stay with the car, Alfred. It might actually be better to see where he's going before we establish a plan.
He seems to be heading into a lower part of downtown Gotham, sir. The part that's, overrun with flora.
Poison Ivy. What do you want with her?
I haven't the foggiest idea, sir. Perhaps we should...
We should wait. I want to see what it is exactly that he wanted from Ivy before we make any kind of action to separate the doctor.
As you wish, sir.
Keep me posted, Alfred.
Oh my goodness. Look at these poor buggers. Standing guard at the door. I wonder what goes through their brains. Utter bliss, perhaps? Or just... emptiness. Either way, it will be a blessing for me. I'm sure they won't stop us, otherwise they would have tried already. Well, I'll say one thing for Poison Ivy. She certainly doesn't entertain much, does she? What would you do, Doctor? If you had the power of Poison Ivy, what would you do? Would you do as she has done? Take over lower downtown Gotham, cover it in various flora, and reclaim the earth for the plants? It's like an eco-protester's wet dream. Now, when we meet her, let me do the talking. All right? If everything goes as smoothly as I'm hoping it will, then we won't have anything to worry about. What is it that I need? A plant that normally grows in a very unique place. And the only way that I am able to retrieve it is to go to someone who can produce plants and flowers on a whim. I thought that that would be a lot simpler way of getting the flower, as it would be to, well, venture 4,000 miles to the Himalayas. So, when we get in, just let me do the talk. All right then. Time to put the old Marcus charm. Well, it worked on you, didn't it, Doctor? But enough. Let's go. Ivy, my dear, allow me to...
Listen to me, Kincaid. I know full well why you've come, and the answer is no. I will not give you the hypodementolia flower. From what I've seen, you seem perfectly willing to kill all in your path, and the world is a much better place without you in it, I'm afraid. Besides, I hope you realize that the flower is not used in medicine to forget, to improve memory.
Just leave that to me, my dear. I assure you, your flowers will be kept in the best conditions. I read a book on the subject.
Well, then you must be an expert on the subject, then.
Believe me, my dear, it's a curse as well as a gift. Do you honestly think I willingly read a book on interesting flora and fungi properties for the sake of it?
Are you saying the study of my babies are a useless occupation?
Not at all. I'm merely stating that I wait for a reason to the contrary. And I... Oh, Pinus... Pinophyta. Such a delightful scent, the pine tree. I can see why you've chosen a pine-based palace as the meeting point.
Every part of the pine tree has medicinal qualities, including the scent, you silly little man. I find it clears my head of all pain. Most of it, anyway. As of yet, you are still here, so I suppose it's not good for all ailments.
I merely wish you to give me the hypodementolia. Then I will be out of your hair for good.
Fine. Take it and get out of my sight. I do not wish to know what you intend to do with it. However, I will say this. Go against the laws of the jungle, and you face the queen. Now you and that stupid Arkham doctor, get out!
It seems you've sprung a leak, my dear. There are puddles of pine sap everywhere.
The poor babies came to me for healing. You would be appalled at the level of contamination Gotham has. Nothing green can naturally grow anywhere near its accursed city. For the last time, both of you leave.
Thank you for the flower, my dear. This will be most beneficial.
I don't care. Just take care of it well and leave. Or do I need to make you into one of my little helpers you saw at the door? Forgetting the laws of the jungle, are we, Kincaid? What are you doing?
There's only one law of the jungle, my dear. When the lion is hungry, he eats.
No! No! What have you done?
Well, Doctor, I think we've overstayed our welcome, don't you? A pine sap, extremely flammable. But enough. I think we need to go. This place seems, well, like it's falling apart anyway. And, well, unless there's any final word you wish to contribute to Poison Ivy? On second thought, I think we better let the poor girl, well, do whatever it is she needs to do. So, shall we, Doctor?
You're not going anywhere, Kincaid. I should have stopped you when you lit the match.
Perhaps you should have done, Batman. What, you didn't think I saw you up there in the rafters? Doctor, if you could do me a favor and just hold the hypodermatolia. Thank you. This day just got a whole lot more interesting. Shall we, Batman?